said, okay, it's episode 2 of season 3, boys. After all the speculation that we've done, speculation about squads, teams, players, potential performances, all of that out of the window, we're now talking straight facts as much as we can. We begin with Mumbai v Bangalore, a marquee clash, marquee captains, beginning in Chennai. And then, of course, there's a big week that's coming up. We're going to talk about every single thing as much as we can. Joined, of course, by Sandeepan Banerjee and Abhishek Mukherjee. Sandeepan, let me come to you. Set this game up for us. It's a big game. Mumbai v Bangalore. Always a lot of tempers. There's a lot of things happening. Last year also, there were a number of sparks flying in this game. What can we expect this time around?
I mean, last year, I think the poster of this game was that stare between Surya and Virat, right?
Yeah, that's what it was. Spicy, very spicy.
Very spicy, yeah. But yeah, it's a good game. I mean, good game to start with. I expect the match to be very competitive, considering the fact that they are playing in Chennai. Hmm. So I don't have any idea about the wicket. Probably we can expect, at least at the start of this, in the first game, we can expect a fresh wicket. And it won't be actually the kind of wicket we are used to see in Chennai, slow low. I don't think that will be. There will be some runs on it. So, yeah, I mean, if both the teams will be looking for early momentum, Mumbai, of course, we know, probably the best T20 team in this globe right now. Mm. And they will be, and if RCB can, come close or, even beat the Mumbai Indians, it will be a perfect start for them. But the question is, RCB won't have their first choice playing 11. And so will be Mumbai, because Quinton de Kock will not be there.
Mm. Abhishek, it's Finn Allen versus the world, right?
Finn Allen. But before that, Chennai. Chennai, we are assuming that Chennai will be a slow, low wicket. See, Chennai, Chepak has a slow, low wicket during IPL because Chennai Super Kings wants it that way. They play their home matches there. They want it that way.
Correct.
If they don't play their home matches there, why would they make that effort? They will prepare a normal sporting wicket.
Historically, what has been the wicket like in Chennai?
Historically, there is a slightly vague depending on how far you want to go back in time. In the 70s, Chennai used to be a fast track.
Mm.
Then it became slow, dead. And around the 90s, when India started relying on spinners, the Chennai pitch started to become a turner. We saw that happen in the 2000s and the 2010s.
Mm.
So there's no reason. I mean, why will they not water the pitch now? Why will they prepare a slow, low pitch? They don't have any incentive.
Correct.
Yeah.
Groundsman is preparing a pitch for two neutral teams.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
Yeah, no longer making it for Talai. So
I mean, I'm not saying it won't be a slow, low pitch. It can be.
Could be.
But we don't know at this point.
The heat of Chennai and all, the soil also is different. So I don't. Yeah, it will be. It will be. It will be. I am also expecting a run scoring wicket over here. But as we probably go forward in this, probably we'll see in the next week or when we'll have the final few games in Chennai, the wicket will actually become a bit slow and low. But to start with, obviously, I think we'll have a high scoring game tomorrow.
Humidity,
and it's a small venue.
Humidity also big factor, right? Big humidity, lots of humidity.
Yes.
And Chepauk will be a smaller ground, so expect a lot of sixes, I guess, from Finn Allen.
Yeah. The moment you step out of the airport, you realize what Chennai humidity is.
It hits you right away.
I mean, you may think Kolkata is humid, you may think Mumbai is humid, but Chennai
they don't come
is on
close.
Another. Yes, yes.
They absolutely. Don't come close at all.
So okay, do you think that on these conditions the barrage of pacers, the pace attack of Mumbai, their prime open, will struggle a little bit. Not exactly struggle, I'd say probably not be on their comfort zone.
See, the thing is, if you are a really good fast bowler, you'll do well on any surface.
Mm. Yeah.
They did well in Mumbai. Mumbai has two very good fast bowlers. They also have a third now. So, fast bowlers, see, fast bowlers of the highest quality will do well on any surface. It's when you come down one level lower, that is when the problems begin. That is when the occasional short pitch ball starts getting bowled or the batsman gets to it. Then the fast ball gets hit across the ground. The fast bowler gets hit across the ground. But given the quality of the Mumbai attack, the Mumbai pace attack, I don't think the pitch is going to be much of a threat.
Yeah, I mean, of course, they did well in UAE last year. So yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So NCN, Bumrah and Bolt.
Bolt, three yes.
Yeah. Similar. Yes. Yeah, with Mumbai, you know that they're not going to make too many changes. This is what it is and they'll stick to it. Simple as that.
Also, they have the three all-rounders. I think that is Mumbai's greatest asset.
100%. And
Hardik is bowling fit.
The great strength of Krunal Pandya, I think the one that sticks out is that he can bowl on any surface, any conditions, because he's not a rank turner. That's one thing.
Krunal Pandya, I think I just checked a few days ago. Krunal Pandya, if you rank by strike rate, put a 1,000 run cap or something, he is among the top 10 in IPL history. If you put a 100 over cap,
yeah,
I think it was 100 overs. He has among the top 10 economy rates in IPL history. So he may not make that one major contribution. He may not make a move. But his contributions build up match by match slowly. He will go, they may go unnoticed, but at the end of the tournament, you'll realize that he has done better than some of his teammates, because he is unlikely to do that one defining performance. There will be many small performances.
Okay, so let's take a look at a potential Mumbai 11. Don't need to be rocket scientist to do this, but Sandeep, let's do it anyway, right? Let's do it anyway, because obviously we spoke Quinton de Kock not around. Who comes in? Do you think Ishan opens, or think they'll just bring in Lin and play Lin for?
Yeah, like Lin is probably a like for like replacement, but playing Lin for one game and then Quinton will come back. I think better if we open with Ishan and Rohit.
Would you do that, Abhishek?
See, if Lin plays, he has to open.
Yeah,
that's what I think. So, if that means dropping Ishan to three, or even Rohit dropping one slot below, I don't mind. But if Lin plays, he has to open.
I think they won't tamper with.
There's no point in playing Lin and not giving him the entire six.
Correct, 100%. Yeah, absolutely. That's his strength. That's where he's excited.
So I'm just saying, I'm not keeping Lin in the scheme of things. So basically, I would like to see Mumbai open with this Ishan and Rohit, and then they may pick another foreign option.
Or an Indian option. Someone like a Saurabh Tiwari, like they did last time as well.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah,
interesting.
Of course. Yes.
So anyway, let's anyway complete the parlor game, right? So Mumbai, if they have an option to either go with Lin, if not Lin, then they open with Ishan and Rohit, with Surya at three, and then Saurabh Tiwari at four, and then Pollard, Pandya, Nathan Kootenail. Is that what it's looking like at this point?
Yeah. Now the question is Chawla or Rahul Chahar?
I think Chawla. I think they'll go with Chawla.
I think one of those things left best to the team management, because they are the ones who are actually watching these people bowl in the nets.
Yeah.
We don't know who is bowling how well at this point, on 8th of April. So I think it will be a team management call. But having said that, given how Chennai has a history of going into matches with finger spinners, how about Jayantia?
Yeah. I mean, Very good option, actually.
Probably just one right-hander too many in RCB. You don't want to take a risk.
Maybe. That's one thing.
Because you look at the middle order, you've got AB, you've got Maxwell, Virat's there as well, and then now no Padikkal also. So probably two, one right-hander too many. If I recollect rightly, the side boundaries are short in Chepauk.
Yes.
So you don't want to take a risk.
Mumbai might even play in place of that foreign player. They can play both the leg spinners, or they can play someone like Jamie Neesham. Jamie Neesham with his all round option can be handy. Because Mumbai have a lot of all-rounders, but still, he will give an...
Problem with Neesham is he is getting out...
A more than handy bat.
Oh, very good batter. Oh, he can hit it out of the park.
Very good batter. We remember the 2019 World Cup match against West Indies.
Yes.
Can yes.
never forget that game. Oh, he can hit it out of the
park. In Chennai's golden days... They used the combination of Murli, Ashwin and Jakati.
Yeah.
The current Chennai side focuses on Harbhajan and Jadeja. And to do well in that side, you actually need... not the current side, until last
year. Yeah.
Do well in the current side, you need to be as good as Imran Tahir. So again, I think somehow they may back a finger spinner to go into this match.
True.
Okay.
I also think they would want to see how Chawla fares early on. Like, you give him that go beginning when you have the leeway, you slip up one, two games here, there, you're at least not at loss of too much. So you see how Chawla fits in, and then anyway, Rahul Jha is there in the offing. So... Also, remember, I think Chawla has played for CSK last season.
Yes.
So, bring that experience in, play it here and see what happens. And then, of course, to finish that 11 up, after Chawla, you have your two superstars, Bolt and Bumrah, to top it up beautifully. So, that's your Mumbai 11. Let's go to Bangalore now. This is where it gets interesting. And I just want to leave it with Abhishek and just sit back and see how this goes.
He's very excited with Bangalore. Yeah, Finn Allen and 10 and any others. I don't care for the other 10. Finn Allen and pick 10 others.
I think I want our viewers to understand what is this absolute fanfare around Finn Allen on this podcast. We've spoken about him in two episodes now. So please go and tell everybody.
You know, he just coined a new term, right? Finfare. Finfare. I think this word may trend during the IPL.
Finfare.
Yeah.
So, see, I have seen, I think he had just one major outing.
Yeah.
He scored 72 in 29 balls or something. But his domestic T20 strike rate is 188. We are not talking of someone in the 150s. We are talking about someone in the 180s. He is... I won't say a 360 degree player, but at least a 250, 260 degree player. He has the entire array of shots. He can hit the ball hard. His miss hits can go for sixes. Of course, we have seen only New Zealand small grounds. But here also the boundary rope will be in.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, he is worth a try to begin with.
Yeah. So, just to give our viewers a visual of this personality, this god-like, mythical structure, well, he looks like that as well. He is 6 foot what? Six? I don't know. Six foot five?
And he keeps wickets.
He keeps wickets. Yeah. He is 6+, right? And he can hit the ball from anywhere to anywhere. And he opens the batting. And RCB have bought him for base price.
I think something like that.
20 lakh rupees.
Yeah, something like that.
But whenever Palekar will be available, that opening slot will be fixed between Palekar and Kohli, right?
That's true.
So, even if Finn plays in the later games, he won't open.
Yeah.
Yeah, interesting. So we're saying Finn plays in the first game. Is that what's happening?
See, that means they might have to sacrifice Dan Christian.
Yeah.
Or Kyle Jamieson.
Or Kyle Jamieson. Kyle Jamieson looks, see, there are advantages and disadvantages of being a tall, fast bowler in India. You can, the ball to the throat of the batsman, causing him discomfort. On the other hand, if you're marginally short, you're gone.
Yeah.
We have seen that happen throughout the IPL history. It
happened with Cotterill last time. Even though it was not playing in India, Cotterill didn't survive because of the same thing. Absolutely.
Cotterill didn't survive because he was at the receiving end against my favorite IPL cricketer. But we'll come to that later.
Mr. De Villiers. Was it about the De Villiers incident? Are you?
No, I'm talking about the Tewatia incident.
Oh, right. He got destroyed twice. All right. Okay. So we're saying Finn Allen opens the batting with Virat tomorrow. Is that what's happening?
I think. Yeah. I would pick Finn Allen ahead of Dan Christian. Also because AB De Villiers isn't too comfortable keeping wickets. That's so correct. This will add that option.
Okay. Okay, Sandeepan, take that 11 forward. How do we build it from
Probably Mohammad Azharuddin will bat at three. Then
he'll bat at three.
He'll come at three. Then obviously, of course, AB at four. Who will bat at five?
Maxwell.
Oh, of course, Maxwell. Maxwell, then Washington Sundar is there.
Jamieson is there.
Yeah, Jamieson is there. But our question is, I mean, whether they will play Jamieson or Dan Christian. That's the question. I think initially, since they have invested so much on Jamieson, they will 100%. Start with probably with they will probably start with Jamieson. Yes.
But there's Shahbaz Ahmed also, don't forget.
Shahbaz Ahmed, I can't see getting a game at least in the first half of this league. But he can make conditions if it is slow and low. But initially they also have Sachin Baby. Mm. So I don't know.
But you anyway have, Patel, to, you have, Patel you have to anyway fill up those slots, right? Shahbaz Ahmed last time was good. I mean, he batted bold, good fielder as well. So anyway, if you get once you Maxwell at five,
and
somebody at six at seven. Then you will have Jamieson, then you will have your other bowlers as well. So you need to fill up those slots.
And Rajat Patidar. I bowler Waseed and Saini Siraj. There is one spot which is a bit tricky at this point. I think one of those uncapped Indian players will take that spot.
Interesting. What are our overall thoughts about this RCB side? At this point of time, they don't have Padikkal, but they're still looking quite formidable, aren't they? Especially in their batting.
One of the things they may want to look is, again, do they have enough spinners?
Yeah, of course. Chahal, Zampa, Wasi.
Yes. So, will two spinners be enough? We were talking about Mumbai, but Mumbai have Bumrah and Bolt. Siraj and Saini are excellent bowlers, but they are not Bumrah and Bolt.
That's true.
Their strength will be spin. So, they will have to put up some sort of... they have to play with five specialist bowlers.
Absolutely. And Virat likes to play with five specialist bowlers.
Yeah. Yes. That's so correct. Maybe add the third spinner.
Yeah, that can be Zampa.
Even if that means sacrificing on an all-rounder, they may go in with their extra spinner because you cannot go in with four spinners and a group of all-rounders against a side like Mumbai. You have to play five bowlers and you have to go for wickets.
And you have to chase, I guess, against Mumbai. That is your best chance.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I think I would rather play one of those Indian uncapped. I'll rather open with one of those Indian uncapped players like probably Prabhu Desai, and I'll play Zampa in place of Finn Allen at this point.
That means that will depend a lot on whether De Villiers is up for wicket keeping.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
That is something there's no update on.
Azharuddin can keep, last, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Last season, De Villiers was clearly not comfortable keeping wickets.
Yeah.
Yeah. Azharuddin can keep, I guess.
I think Azhar can keep, but I'm not too sure, but I have seen images of him with gloves on from memory. Yeah. That's all I can say.
So again, I guess these are the 11 as of now. Actually, we have predicted 12, not 11. But you know, we are not seeing the net visuals from the nets.
No, and also with RCB, you never really know because they make so many changes. They tinker things around last moment here and there. Last year also, they did so much tinkering that at the end of the day, you only knew that Virat and AB are the two fixed guys. Baki sab to pata bhi nahi chala. All right, contests. In the history
of IPL, Mumbai and Chennai have made the fewest changes throughout the history of IPL because they do not react immediately to defeats. Exactly. They know that defeats can happen,
which is something that Virat did way too often last time around. I feel
way too much. See, if a player feels that if my side loses, I may be dropped immediately. It is difficult for that player, especially if that player is a fringe player, to do well.
Because that player's urge to perform comes from an insecure space, right?
And the more that happens, if a player knows that his place is under threat, he will stop going. He will stop trying for a 12 ball 20 and will focus on playing a 15 ball 20.
Yes,
correct. Exactly.
You have to give that bowler a long run, or he may not want to go for a wicket. What if my over goes for runs?
Yeah,
correct. Play it safe, and that sort of performance doesn't win you games. It just doesn't.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
All right. Let's take a look at matchups. This is one narrative in T20 coverage today, or coverage of cricket today, that has taken precedence. You're always looking at 1v1 in a sport which is 11v11. What are the couple of matchups that we're excited to look at in game one, Mumbai v Bangalore?
Bolt versus Kohli.
Left arm. Right. Yeah. That's what it is.
Mumbai, any leg spinner versus Virat Kohli. Any leg spinner.
Chawla ji.
Chawla
Chahar. I'm actually looking
RCB
forward
selectors
to
selectors versus Finale.
Versus you've already pitted him against the leadership team. Yeah. It's a situation that a lot of Bangalore players are used to already, so it's okay. It's fine.
What about there's another interesting matchup, Ishan versus Chahal.
Ishan versus Chahal is a good one. Ishan versus Chahal is a good one indeed. I am actually really keen to see how Kyle Jameson goes about it. So Jameson versus Lin or Rohit at the top is something I'm looking forward to. I know Rohit likes bounce, but
if Jameson gets that length right.
Yeah.
If he can really get the ball to come at the batsman's throat, then we are in for a great contest.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I mean, these guys like bounce. Mumbai's openers like bounce. Quinton in the long run likes bounce. Rohit likes bounce. Surya likes bounce. But like Abhishek said, if he gets that length right and if he gets some movement of the surface, takes the pace off nicely, he could be a dangerous bowler. I'm actually looking forward to seeing him. Quite the journey he's had. All right, so those are some key contests. Anything else?
Maxwell versus Maxwell.
Yeah.
He is the only one who standing between himself and success.
Wow. Yeah. RCB, the latest team to fall into the whole process of investing faith in Maxwell, right? Another team, another team has now put that faith in.
Interestingly, it all started with Mumbai.
It all started with Mumbai. It's come a full circle. But let's see. I actually want to read out what Maxwell said in the press. He said, "I'm not overly concerned. I think my performances will take care of themselves. I want to have a positive influence on the team, help Virat out with leadership when possible, on and off the field, making sure young guys are developing well."
That is another thing. They lack that senior figure. Other than Virat and AB, they lack that senior person.
Yeah. For a long time, the leadership was Virat and AB. That's it. They didn't have anybody else to look at all. Unlike Mumbai, when a situation arrives, there are 2, 3, 4 people who come in and they solve it and then go back. But interesting, right? They had Finch last time. Finch didn't work out.
But yeah, it did not work out. I mean, with Finch, it happens. He has played for how many IPL? 6 IPL teams? 6 or 7?
Exactly. Why Finch doesn't succeed in IPL is a mystery to me. Because it's the same format. It's the same. He has got runs here. There's no doubt about his class in T20 cricket.
Yeah.
It's just one of those things.
Maxwell and Finch, right? I feel these are like the English players in the Premier League and when they're playing for the national team. For the national team, you don't know where they're gone. For the Premier League, they're like, oh, we can take on Messi on any given day also. This dynamic is something which is samajh ke bahar, 100%. All right, so that was about the opening game, Mumbai versus Bangalore. It's going to be a big game. We're going to enjoy it. But there's a lot more coming in the week, right? There's so much happening. Our weeks are going to be Friday to Thursday. So there are about 9 games, a couple of double headers coming post that as well. So Sandeepan, what are the couple of games we're looking forward to in week one? Give us your 5 games that you're looking forward to, that our viewers can sort of keep their eyes on.
Well, Chennai Delhi will be a good game. Second match. Chennai finished... Dhoni versus Pant, Chennai finished last. Delhi, you know, with a new captain. It would be interesting to see whether Delhi can maintain their, you know, will Rabada and Nokia will be available for the first game, right? So Delhi will be almost their full strength.
Yeah. I mean, I heard CSA are releasing players that are in.
Yes. So they have already, you know, have gone through the required quarantine and all. So I hope that Delhi will... So I would like to see how, like I was mentioning in the other podcast as well, I'd like to see how those two South African bowlers maintain their form and fitness this year also.
Yeah.
Because Delhi's scheme, game plan, a lot depends on them. A lot depends on those two players.
Yeah.
But Pant's captaincy, it will be interesting to see Pant's captaincy. And of course, Dhoni. The only problem is that this Chennai team, there is apart from Sam Curran, there is no power hitter at all. I mean, if you consider their second best power hitter is probably Ravindra Jadeja. So
I think what they can do, what they are likely to do is use one of their batsmen. See, Chennai have a lot of batsmen who can switch gears.
That's
so maybe one of them may assume a different role.
That can be
anyone.
Moin Ali can do.
We have seen Moin Ali do that a couple of seasons ago.
And in the test matches, like recently, Chennai test.
He can. So
he's a good
whether he'll be used in that role. Yeah. That is another story altogether.
Well, tell us.
The question is, Chennai, and another interesting aspect of Chennai is, will Suresh Raina have the same sort of an impact? I really doubt. But he, and Chennai, most of the they're into this type, you know, without having played any, have played that some practice games.
Yes.
So that there is not that, much of...
I have said this before, I think. That hurt Chennai more than any other team in 2020.
That's true.
You are a are the team with the average oldest age. Chennai have several cricketers who are not part of national side. Not uncapped cricketers.
Yeah, yeah.
Cricketers who are past their prime, who do not Chennai cricketers are out of action, as Sandeep yeah. said. That had been a problem in 2020. That may be a problem in 2021. But in 2020, that came all of a sudden. In 2021, they have had time to address that. I'm sure they must have done preparations. They have known this beforehand. Yeah. They must have prepared accordingly. Yeah.
So, I mean, that is one concern. So I expect Chennai to be a bit rusty, you know, in their first few games.
Maybe.
And so I guess Delhi will go into this game as favorites, but you never know. Chennai. And the other fact is Chennai struggles at Wankhede. That is another fact.
Yeah. But again.
Again, the wicket.
Pitches may not be the same as we have seen.
Okay. The other game I am very keen on watching, that is Sunrisers versus KKR. I am very much willing to see what combination KKR picks. This is probably the first game in post-Naren era. KKR is trying to get rid of that, over-dependency on Naren and Russell. So, you know, probably even Naren will not even be picked in the first game. So, they will probably go ahead with Shakib.
Absolutely. And bat Shakib at three, boss. 100%.
Open with Shakib.
Open. Even better. Open. Nitish Rana
won't be available for the first game.
Rana's not
there. They can definitely open.
Yeah.
If you have an aggressive batsman, this is T20 cricket, you have 6 hours of power play. Make full use of him. Open with Shakib.
And it's a good point opening with Shakib against Sunrisers, because they have the swing bowlers like Sandeep Sharma and Bhubi to bowl with the new ball. So if we play a pinch hitter over there, he can be worked out. But someone of a well-accomplished, technically solid batsman like Shakib, I think if he can play Bhubi's initial spell out, then I think KKR will do
it. Kolkata-Hyderabad is always a derby that doesn't get
biryani derby, right?
Because we have hype for the better biryani. So
it's the biryani derby.
Yeah, biryani derby.
Nice. I think I'm going to stick to that. Never going to call it by the franchise's names. It's going to be called biryani derby.
Biryani derby.
100%. I'm actually looking forward to Rajasthan Punjab. These games turn out to be crackers. You never expect them, and they just explode.
Punjab.
Tevatiya became Tevatiya in last year's Rajasthan Punjab match.
Exactly, exactly, yeah. Exactly. He became what he was there, and I think this time Rajasthan are much more well-rounded, especially because they finally let go of the whole hanging sword Steve Smith situation, and they can play a fourth deserving foreign player, seamer or even a batter.
I think they got stuck with Smith and Rahane. The problem was they are fantastic cricketers. They had picked him. Now they could not pick him in the squad and then bench him.
Yeah, so, correct. Yeah.
And there was no senior figure. So they were stuck in some sort of dilemma over what to do with them.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Now they look a lot free.
Yeah. 100%.
So these teams,
they can play Livingstone. They can either play Liam Livingston or they can play Andrew Tai, Mustafizur Rahman, depending on what they want to go.
Where they are playing?
What they're playing
in Wankhede.
They're playing in Bombay. Wankhede. So run fest. Yeah. I feel it's going to be a run fest that game.
So Maurice and Mustafizur can come in
and open with Stokes and Butler.
I think Sanju opens. I hope Sanju and Butler opens, and I think that'll be.
I think Sanju will bat at number 3.
Where did Stokes get that 100 last time?
Opening.
Opening, right?
Yes. Come on. And that's true, with the current form Stokes is in, I think he should definitely open. But Stokes and Butler, that will be a bit top heavy. So they don't have...
They've always been top heavy. Tevatiya came and saved their face many times.
The problem is the middle order. Now, this time, They have a long string of all-rounders.
And I think their lower middle order is fabulous this time. You look at Dubey, Tevati and Morris. I think very, very good lower middle order. Very good lower.
Yeah. In fact, they have enough good Indian pace bowlers as well. The one of the uncapped bowlers, the Sakaria, that is Unadkar. Mm. So if they can play one of them, then they can accommodate David Miller into the playing 11 as well. In the middle order.
That's also an option. But I think Livingstone is the one who gets the nod, I think, ahead of Miller.
I think they may go in with Stokes, Butler, Morris and Mustafizur.
Yeah. But Mustafizur hasn't been doing well of late, you know. So you don't know what to expect from Mustafizur.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. I think the plan was anyway to have somebody to bowl, you know, alongside Archer, like Morris and Archer bowl together. Because he was getting isolated. So now I think they would still try and be like, fine, let's play two overseas fast bowlers and then see how the tournament progresses.
So the other alternative is Andrew Tye.
Yeah,
absolutely. Mm. If Tye can start bowling 150, where he made his mark in IPL 2017, I guess, for Punjab, and he can start.
So one reason why Mustafizur left out is. They as in Rajasthan, already have a couple of left-arm seamers, Indian left-arm seamers.
Yeah.
So even if they do not pick Mustafizur, they can go in with, say, Unadkar.
Or Sakaria.
Yeah.
But now the question is Punjab, I would like to see their, I hope that this time around they will get their combinations right. I mean, they have sorted, they are trying to find the luck through their name changes, like what happened with Delhi, or maybe you can say Sunrisers Hyderabad. But I guess, you know, Punjab, the problem has been, I mean, they don't know whom to bat at the top, who will bat in the middle order. So, in last year, their problem was bowling. So, this year, they sorted it out by investing 22 crores on these two guys.
I mean,
Richardson and Merited, yeah. So, and now I think Moises Henriques is a good pick. He can add that balance in the middle order.
They are the same, yeah. Jordan and Hendricks are the same, right? They're pretty much the same profile players.
Yeah, but I think this time Jay Richardson can make a difference. Mm-hmm. He will open the bowling with Sami, and then they have the spinners. I think, remember Ravi Bishnoi and M. Ashwin. They did well, fantastically I guess, last year.
Very good. The problem with Punjab was the seam bowling. 100%. So they went for 8 runs plus.
Punjab faced last year was Rahul and Mayank batted and scored a lot of runs.
Yeah.
But they kept that final onslaught for too late. The onslaught was always delayed. Yeah. Whenever Rahul and Mayank got those big partnerships, the big hitting began too late.
Yeah.
So in other words, the likes of Puran came in too late into play. That is something that needs to. That Punjab ended up scoring 10 to 15 runs fewer on multiple occasions. That has to change. I think I read somewhere that Rahul has promised that he will be back to his 2016-17 avatar instead of 2019. In 2019, he scored more runs, but he was more effective in 2016-17. If you have Gale and Puran following that kind of an opening pair, you don't need to be that extra cautious.
Yeah. Yeah. I think Wasim Jaffer, Punjab's batting coach, has recently mentioned that Rahul will be a bit more proactive at the top this week.
Yes. Yes.
He has to.
So why can't they open with Rahul and Gale? I mean, Mayank can easily fit in the middle order. They have a bit of an inexperience in the middle order. So Mayank can take care. Mayank, Puran, and someone like Shahrukh Khan,
But the problem is, after 4-5, there is no batting. That is the issue. You're top heavy. Your top, you can rotate. Anybody can play anywhere. But after Puran, right? After Puran, who? Then there's Shahrukh Khan, and then who else? Then you go straight to Chris
Mandeep
Jordan.
Mandeep's
there, and then you go straight to Chris
Mandeep
Jordan.
Mandeep is there.
That's it.
Sarfaraz is there. I mean, last year what happened? Maxwell did not click. That's their main issue.
I honestly feel number six is a huge position in T20 cricket. It's massive. If you don't have someone like a Pollard, someone like a Jadeja, Hardik. You know, big Hardik, these big guys, you're struggling. And Punjab don't have that player even this year, which is where I think they're going to struggle this time as well.
So you think that, I mean, that's why they picked Henriquez, but accommodating him in the playing 11 will be tough. You have to sacrifice probably one of their fast bowlers, or either Gail and Puran can play.
I think six, they're going to play Shah Rukh Khan this year. And
this is where I would nominate Fabian Allen.
Trump card.
But Moses Henriquez have been doing well off late. I mean, he missed the IPL for the last three seasons, I guess. Yes. But yes. In South Africa, in Australia, BBL and all, he has been doing fairly well.
I mean, Moses Hendrix, at the end of the day, season campaigner. He knows this league in and out. He's been around for a while. He knows this league. Okay. This moves us nicely into our last segment, which is the players to watch out for. Lau, let's talk about five players. Yes, you can include Finn Allen.
Finn Allen?
Okay.
Rahul Tewatia?
Okay, two.
Chris Gayle.
Three. Sandeepan?
Shakib Al Hasan.
Four.
Okay. And what else? Who else? And probably
Glenn Maxwell. Maxwell ko bhool gaya. Maxwell.
Maxwell is like, you know, it's a.
Forgot Maxwell.
Prithvi Shaw.
Old wine in a new bottle. Yeah.
Old wine.
Same thing.
Prithvi Shaw.
Prithvi Shaw.
Yeah, you can say Prithvi Shaw. I would rather say Sam Curran.
Prithvi Shaw is in superhuman form.
Let's see how that translates to IPL.
Exactly. And also, let's see how he responds to the Ponting comments. Did anyone read that?
Yes.
I hope. I mean, let's hope he takes it in the right stride for Delhi. Otherwise, they're doomed. They're doomed for sure.
Let's see what happens.
Interesting. All right. Okay. That was fun. So the five players we're looking forward to have been named as well. The games we're looking forward to as have been named as well. All that's left is for the cricket to happen. And guess we're so excited that we could pad up and go out there and bat, but we leave that to Finn Allen now, shall we? Right?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. All right. This is fun. Okay. Thanks a lot, gentlemen. Let's predict. Before we sign off, let's predict. What's the table going to look like at the end of week one? Who's going to be on top?
Mumbai playing two games, right?
Mumbai
will be top. Yeah, they will be top. They are playing Kolkata in the second game. So, of course, they will win that.
Oh, that is so sad. That's Sandeepan, the fan, has spoken. Itna bhi bura mat mano yaar, koi baat nahi.
Mumbai is used to Kolkata is one game that Mumbai, that is their insurance policy. That okay, chalo, ye do game hum jeetenge, baki dekh lenge. Dekhe, actually Mumbai they have struggled against Punjab. Quite strange. I don't know why. I have no idea.
And they lose one game versus Rajasthan or Hyderabad once in a while, here and there. That's it.
Yeah. They struggle against Punjab each year, every year, and they kept beating Kolkata each year. So
correct.
I am used to it.
All right, and what's the team that will struggle to take off?
Rajasthan, of course. My support has always held them back.
What about CSK? Rusty.
So CSK are playing Delhi. CSK are playing Delhi, and then they're playing Punjab.
I think CSK will struggle to take off.
They're going to lose two out of two.
They are playing two matches in Wankhede. So, I guess CSK. I'll put my money on CSK.
Same, I suppose.
All right. Okay, Mumbai to take off and CSK to tank. Seems like the story of last year, but it could be entirely different. But, we'll be back. Of course, we'll be back with more stories as time goes on. This was episode 2 of the podcast. Episode 3 will be out very, very soon next week as well. We'll bring you the major moments from week 1 via Sandeepan, Abhishek and myself, Sumedh, on the cricketnews.com podcast with me, Sumedh Bilgi. This is a pleasure. Go and enjoy the cricket now. And make sure you pick Finn Allen in your fantasy team, right? 100%. Okay, go ahead, do that.
Of course.
We'll see you around.